There's so many emotions, blood, sweat, and tears that go into having a great game in any sport. But when a loved one passes away, something happens. Something goes off inside that player that makes them play like never before, that makes them do whatever it takes to win a game. It's something that no amount of hard work or dedication can recreate. It's an emotion that can only be tapped into in the time of a terrible event. These six players have experienced what it's like and did whatever it took to win their game in honor of their lost friend or family. We're gonna take a look at these six players, starting with number six, Isaiah Thomas. Sadly, Isaiah Thomas is the most recent person on this list to experience a game like this. As most of you probably remember, right before the 2017 playoffs, Isaiah Thomas's sister, China, passed away after her car slammed into a metal pole. She was going 50 miles per hour and not wearing a seatbelt. After the news broke, Isaiah Thomas wanted to quit basketball, but instead, he realized that he had to keep going for her. He said everything that he does for the rest of his life will be for her, so he played in the 2017 playoffs. He averaged 23 points a game to beat the Bulls in the first round, then went on to score 53 on China's birthday.
Isaiah, where is this coming from, man? Where is this coming from?
It's my sister. It's her birthday today. Happy birthday. She would have been 23 today, so everything I do is for her.
So the least I can do is go out there and play for her. I mean, I wanted to win for her, and I wanted to play well for her, so luckily we got the win.
He averaged 27 points a game against the Wizards to help the Celtics beat them in the second round, before sitting out against the Cavs due to an injury. There's no telling how good Isaiah Thomas would have played against the Cavaliers for China. Number 5, Brett Favre. Brett Favre and his father, Irvin Favre, were extremely close. Irvin even coached Brett throughout his time in high school, but on December 21st, 2003, Irvin Favre would suddenly die after a heart attack. One day later, Brett Favre decided to still play in his game against the Oakland Raiders. I mean, it was a smart choice because he had over 300 yards and 4 touchdowns in the first half alone. He finished the game with 399 yards. It was a monster game and led his team to a 41-7 victory.
Under the perfect circumstances, I've never been able to do what I've done in that game.
You watch the game and it was like, this is like a movie. How is this happening? Is it luck? Is it his teammates making plays for him?
If there was ever divine intervention, he was there that night.
Number 4, Kurt Angle. Now this is one that I heard about a few years back in a Kurt Angle interview. I can't find the interview anymore, so all the details might not be exactly right. But if you're unaware, Kurt Angle is a professional wrestler and Olympic gold medalist. But before all that, he was a pretty good running back in high school. His dad used to go to every single one of his games. So when he died when Kurt was only 16, Kurt went to his next game alone. He said he ran for 5 touchdowns, 200 yards, and broke more tackles than he ever had before. Number 3, Quan Alexander. Quan was a 4th round draft pick at linebacker in the 2015 NFL Draft. On October 30th, 2015, his younger brother was shot and killed during an argument. 2 days later, on November 1st, 2015, Quan Alexander would play one of the best games of his NFL career. He had 11 tackles, an interception, forced a fumble, had a fumble recovery, and all this played a big part in leading the Buccaneers to a win over the Atlanta Falcons. After the game, he went to his brother's school and held a meeting with all of his closest friends, and they had a candle lighting for him.
Here. This guy here did today, guys. That's something special.
Number 2, Torrey Smith. In 2012, wide receiver of the Baltimore Ravens, Torrey Smith's brother, died in a motorcycle accident. It was said that he ran off the road and hit a light pole. Even though he was wearing a helmet, it didn't make a difference in the outcome of the crash. Torrey Smith heard of the news at 1 a.m. that night, so he rushed home to be with his family and only got an hour of sleep. But at 4 p.m. that same day, he decided that with no sleep, he would play in their game that day against the Patriots. So Torrey caught 2 touchdown passes for 127 yards. One of those passes was to bring the Ravens within 2 points. Then they went on to kick a field goal and win the game. It wasn't the most insane performance ever, but it was a great game less than 24 hours after hearing the news of his brother. And he got the touchdown to set up the game winner. After the game, he said,
"It's new territory for me. Yeah, bro. You know, a loss like this, man. And, you know, if it wasn't for y'all, I don't think I would have even been here today. You know, it's tough, man. I appreciate all the support. You know, y'all really made me feel better. Appreciate y'all. Love all y'all, coaches, players, everyone, man.
Number one, John Wall. In March of 2014, John Wall met a young 6-year-old girl named Maya Nelson who had cancer. He became really good friends with her, and he kept in touch with her and FaceTimed her a lot, and even started a campaign on social media to help Maya meet her idol, Nicki Minaj. They became really close, so it crushed John Wall when she lost her battle with cancer on December 8th, 2014. John Wall wrote her name on his shoes that night and went on to score 26 points and have 17 assists to beat the Boston Celtics in double overtime. After the game, he said, well, just see for yourself.
You see a little kid that fights so hard for cancer and can't beat it. She really touched your heart, didn't she? Buck, obviously, John's very emotional, guys. We'll send it back to you.
So this has been 6 players with insane games after the death of a loved one. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out my other videos and like and subscribe to not miss more videos like this coming soon.